What do I got? What's that spell? Trouble. Jasmine. It's actually not that bad, guys and gals. But let me flip open the thing here so I can see what I'm filming. There we go. It's got some high frets around the body joint, which is otherwise known as hump my acoustic guitar. So the weird part about that is sometimes these don't stand up high unless there's string tension on the guitar. So this is going to get new strings, but for getting rid of this fret problem here, I'll put the camera in a different position and show you what's going on here in a second. Hold on. Here we are. Let's tune it up a little bit first. Here. Research is required. What's going on here? Yep. But see, only there. So that guy as well. This handy thing. Where's my blue marker? Well, I'm thinking I may have to level the whole tail end of the fretboard here to get this right. Let's see what happens. So, upon closer inspection, rather than get into a whole bunch of big fretwork, I'm thinking I may be able to solve this by adjusting the truss rod and putting a very, very tiny shim underneath the bridge saddle. So I'm going to try that first. And if that doesn't succeed, well, at that point, we're going to be shaving a bunch of frets here at the body joint. It's really not that bad. And the playability's like really good. The string action isn't, you know, high or anything, but it's just a little inconsistent around the old body joint. I'm wondering if I stick the humidifier in it for a couple days if something's going to change there. Not really. This thing sat in a work truck for weeks and months. It's dried out like a matchbox. Let's begin. That was a way smarter solution than grinding the frets. Especially since there was really no problem down here in cowboy land. Cool. Problem solved. Let's clean it up, put some new strings on it. Call up my buddy and tell him it's time to come get it. New strings. Yay, Skycam. Let's clean the marker off the frets. And then while we're at it, let's just clean all the shit off the frets. The Never Dull does a good job, but there's nothing like some fine grit sandpaper to get off all the tarnish and finger spritz, hand spritz. much nicer. Fretboard needs a serious scrub-a-dub-dub. So once again, the this magic brush, if you don't have that, get yourself a toothbrush. This gets right in there. Oh, look at that. When you see the brown suds, you know you're getting her. Excuse me a minute here while I find the poop blanket. Yeah. I think we're gonna go around two with the brush on this one again. Whatever you do, if you use this simple green stuff, never leave it on. Like, never leave it. It's meant to be sprayed on, manipulated, and removed. That's looking pretty good. I'm going to go another round. Watch. Let's get a little linseed on the rosewood. Okay, gonna answer a million questions all here right now, right in a row. Actually, no, I'm gonna clean the frets first with Neverdol, and then I'm gonna do the linseed. Okay, the linseed oil was handed down to me by a guy who's no longer on planet Earth. He's left the planet. And the reason we like it is because it congeals, it solidifies over time, so that when we push it into the grain of the rosewood, linseed oil is not good for a maple neck. It doesn't do anything. It's for open grain wood. What happens is it congeals in the open grain of the wood, the tiny minute amount that we leave behind. All right, so we never leave this on. If you did enough coats of linseed oil, you could actually produce like a finish, you know. Common use for this is wooden outdoor furniture. Wooden bolt. Like I said, we're just gonna push that in. Never leave that on either. Just put it on, wipe it off. Look at that. Looks like a brand new guitar. Next, we'll clean up the body, put the new strings on it. Run away. Well, walk away. I don't run so fast anymore. Also did a couple drops of linseed oil on the rosewood bridge as well. And, man, okay, and what's the other thing? Once again, plugging these guys. I have actually gotten sort of hooked on this product. Where's my clean cloth? I had one here somewhere. This stuff is pretty not bad, even though the pumper is gooched on this. After a little bit of help, it starts to work. And we rub that around until it starts to disappear. And it works pretty good. I really am, you know, impressed with how well it cleans up. I hope the camera's picking that up. But I guess you can only order this online. Somebody's telling me Music Nomad Equipment Care. This product, they make a whole bunch of stuff. This one is called The One. The Guitar One. Complete guitar maintenance in one bottle. And, yeah. I'm liking it. So there it is on the back. Man. This stuff works really well. Guitar's like whew, slippery. This is a set of strings that was a gift from a YouTube user, so I'm going to stab them on this this guitar for my buddy. Cool. Yeah, just I guess give these guys a good plug. Strings Are Us. I think it's a web-based sort of thing. They look pretty good. We'll see what they sound like. And then I had someone asking me how to string a guitar. I'm sure there's way better videos on it than I could do. But I'll just, one little pointer that I use when I'm winding strings down here to get the correct number of winds. On a peg head like this, let me just give me down a little bit. Take the string, the plain strings, the wound ones are different, plain one. I take the string and go just to the next tuning peg, and that's where I put my bend. I don't knot the strings. I've never found it to be of any advantage that I know about. It's a bit of a disadvantage when you have to change the string quickly in a pinch in the dark where there's, you know, little resource, let alone a bench to work on. If you don't have one of these winders, I can tell you, it's no fun. Snap! Okay, that's how I put on a string. I'm not tuning that to pitch till I get more string tension on the neck. That can bust your brand new string for you. When I'm putting a wound string on, I'll take the distance. I'll go about 3/4 of the distance between these two pegs, and then put a kink in it and start the wind. And always keeping the winds under, not over, not overlapping each other and making a big mess. Sometimes it's a little tricky to get it right. But after about 1,000 guitars, you get pretty good at it. More tuning to come later. Just for the history books, Jasmine, I can never Takamine? Takamine, made in Chinkening, and China, the Model S341. Let's make a chord. Importantly, all the frets work now. Cheers, folks. Here it is. I better trim the strings for him, I guess.